But I know from experience that B. Smith can be a very cool and calculating customer.
You mean she could be faking this whole thing?
It's a possibility we can't overlook.
And if she's not faking?
Then there's no question about it. Smith must be sent to a mental institution.
Now, you got to tell me the truth about Debbie and all this hocus-pocus.
There never was a message from Debbie. Nola.
And who? You got to tell me.
Oh, it doesn't matter, Lizzie. Look, if I'd known what was going to happen, I wouldn't have let them bully me into it.
Well, they're not going to bully me, the bloody mongrels.
B. Debbie.
Shh. B. B, love, it's me. Lizzie.
Oh. My head feels like it's going to explode.
Oh. I've been sitting here for ages. I reckon Mrs. M's covering for me. You had us all really worried.
Losing my mind. Losing my going mad.
Of course you're not, love, but the bloody Nola and the freak want you to think you are.
What? Oh. I don't know what you're talking about.
They want you to go bonkers. That's why they bullied Zara into all that clap. Trap about Debbie's ghost.
Debbie was there, I heard her.
You heard Zara B. That's what I'm trying to tell you. You heard Zara. They want you to think you're going mad. They even tried to get you to kill yourself.
Kill? No. Debbie just wanted me to be nearer.
Oh, well, Debbie didn't make this, did she? That's Nola's handiwork.
But what about the note? The note from Debbie?
Yeah, I got that in me pocket too. Here.
Then it was on the press. I didn't imagine it.
Of course you didn't, but those bloody mongrels wanted you to.
God, why would anyone want to do that?
They wanted you to think that you were mad. They wanted to get rid of you once and forever.
They nearly did. Debbie, I was so sure.
Come on, love. It's all right now. Nobody knows about it except me and Zara. I didn't even tell the governor about it until I checked up with you.
You're a good mate, Lizzie. You did right. There's just one other thing I want you to do for me.
She must be really going off her rocker if she wants to see Nola. But you should hear her carrying on about all the rotten things she's done. And all she wants is a chance to apologise.
Well, I'm sorry, Lizzie. I can understand your feeling, but I'm afraid until Dr. Pullman agrees to allow visitors, it's just not possible.
Oh, but Mrs. Reynolds, you should have heard her. It's tearing her apart to think that she's hurting Debbie. Oh, you know how a mother feels, Mrs. Reynolds. Oh, I'm sorry, Mrs. Reynolds, but I'm just scared that Bea'll never get better if we don't ease her mind. She's got it into her head that if she doesn't say she's sorry to Nola, she'll lose Debbie forever. So we gotta help her.
All right, Lizzie, now calm down.
I reckon she's asleep.
B, I've brought Mackenzie to see you.
Oh, this is a bloody waste of time. Can I go now?
No. I haven't got long. I've got to tie up some loose ends.
The great Queen Bee. Getting ready to meet your maker, eh, Smith?
That's enough, Mackenzie. You can see how ill she is.
Debbie and Patty. They're crying. They're so sad because they're alone.
Oh, she's off her bloody brain. Doesn't make any sense at all.
Bee, do you want to say anything to Mackenzie?
Yeah. Noah. Come here.
Okay, Smith. But make it quick, eh?
Debbie and Patty. They're both waiting. Both waiting.
For you.
Needn't worry, Mrs. Morris. I'm not going to bump myself off. Not now, anyway.
Why on earth did you do it, Bee? There must be a reason.
Oh, there was. A bloody good one. That bitch was trying to drive me mad. And she damn nearly succeeded.
What?
All those whisperings and voices in the night? It wasn't Debbie. It was Zara, with a little help from her friends.
I don't believe it.
It's true, all right. Only Zara got cold feet when things started to get out of hand. And she told Lizzie.
Why on earth would she want to do something like that?
To drive me mad. I knew that thinking it was Debbie is the only thing that would make me crack. And the gun that Lizzie found planted in my cell, I mean, I was supposed to use it on myself.
But Zara hardly knew you.
It wasn't her idea. She was having her arm twisted by Ferguson and Mackenzie.
Ferguson? Are you sure she was involved?
Well, who else? I mean, we don't exactly have two screws who think like her now, do we? And a screw has to have been involved. All that midnight prowling and so on.
Yeah, I see what you mean.
Yeah, well, no more. No more voices. And no more Debbie. I reckon you can only be taken in by something like that if you really want to be. Who and I wanted to be. I thought somehow my daughter and I could be together again. And they made me believe it could happen. And for that, I'll never forgive them.
Right, Rich, why don't you just come inside and shut the door behind you? You might as well, because I'm going to get you sooner or later.
You keep it quiet, Smith, and go easy on the accusations. People will think you're raving again.
I wouldn't be too sure about that.
Anything you say will just be put down to your sudden and sad decline.
Yeah? Or not when they see this.
Oh, what's that supposed to be?
That is a note from Debbie.
Oh, been writing yourself notes now, have you? Debbie's dead, Smith.
This is in Debbie's handwriting. As the one you and Mackenzie wrapped around the gun. Recognise it?
Oh, I feel so alone now. Can't you come to see me? Never seen her before in my life.
Thanks. That's all the proof I needed.
Oh, you're crazy, Smith. It's useless.
I don't think so. And I'm going to give it to the cops.
What does that prove? If it is a letter from your daughter, what the hell does it prove?
That someone brought it in here.
Well, now, if it's in Debbie's handwriting, it must be pretty old. They'll say you've been hoarding it up.
Wrong. Because I haven't got a single thing left from her, not a single thing. It all went in the fire.
Is that so? Well, that must be one that got away. You've probably been carrying it around for years.
Where'd you get it, Ferguson? Who was it written to?
Like I said, I've never seen it before in my life.
Try proving it.
And you finish up in a padded cell.
You know something about this letter?
Steady,
bitch!
Smith!
I'm going to get you. I'll get you sooner or later. You're never going to get away with this, you rotten bitch. I'm going to get you.
What the hell's going on here?
Just Smith's wild ravings again.
Oh, nice try, Ferguson, but I'm going to get you.
All right, shut up, Smith.
I don't want to see the governor.
Yes, you will in due course if you're quiet.
Can you give any reason why you think Mackenzie was shot?
In my opinion, it was only a matter of time. They were arch enemies from the moment they met. They were constantly at each other's throats. Smith resented any influence Mackenzie had over the women. Before Mackenzie arrived, Smith was the undisputed leader.
Thank you, Miss Ferguson.
Witness, you may step down.
You've got to find some way of showing that she and Mackenzie were trying to drive me insane.
Unless we can get Zara Moonbeam's cooperation, we don't stand a chance.
Mackenzie and Ferguson have been trying to drive me mad for weeks. I loved my daughter, and they tried to make me believe that I was hearing her voice.
Now you say it was Zara Moonbeam's voice. Wouldn't you know the difference?
They got me to the point where I was ready to believe anything, don't you see?
No, Mrs. Smith, I do not. I suggest that your unhealthy fascination with the afterlife has nothing whatsoever to do with the crime in question. I further suggest that you deliberately set out to murder the deceased purely to re-establish your position in the prison hierarchy.
No!
It would appear there is a possibility of emotional stress as a cause of the crime. However, I am not entirely convinced that emotional stress was the sole cause, as there appear to be many other factors involved. Therefore, the court has decided that there is a prima facie case for murder against the defendant Smith, and one for accessory prior to the murder against the defendant Birdsworth. Both the accused will be committed for trial in the Supreme Court on a date to be fixed.
I was wondering when you'd show up, B.
I'm not surprised, because you're in trouble, Grandma. Big trouble.
Oh, that's very observant of you, B. I've got 20 years in the pen, and you tell me I'm in trouble. I should never have known.
Don't you get too clever with me, Kennedy. You might be too old to give a thumping, but there's more than one way of dealing with your kind.
Now, just a minute, B. You've got me down as a pusher. Well, I'm not, and I never have been. Okay. So I had a fair idea of what I was carrying, but I didn't know for sure. And I figured, as long as I didn't, it didn't matter. I mean, as long as the money was all...
You filthy old hypocrite. Where do you think that money came from? Kids, very sick kids.
Oh, yes, honey, I know, and it's very sad, but we're all given the same chances in life now.
My God! You're worse than I thought. Well, I don't give much for your chances, lady, not when the others find out what fools you've made of them.
Don't you underestimate me, B. I've taken out a little insurance in case of anything like that happening.
Oh, this should be good.
It is. My lawyer is getting a letter tomorrow, and he has instructions to open it if anything happens to me.
Well, complete with a list of names and mine at the top, right?
Something like that.
Nice try, Kennedy. But it won't work. You see, I've got nothing to lose. I'm here for the duration.
Right. Judy Bryant suggested you might like some of my photos to decorate your room, so here they are with my compliments and apologies. Yours sincerely, Paul Reynolds.
Kind of him, isn't it? Offloading his rubbish onto us.
Oh, I think he's really sweet.
Oh, I like this one.
Hey, you beauty, here's one of a mob of bikers.
Oh, anyone we know?
I don't know how you can tell. They all wear helmets and dark glasses.
I don't recognise their leathers, Lizzie.
Now, there's a familiar face. Ted Douglas.
Is it?
Oh, put your glasses on, Lizzie.
Struth, he's gone up in the world.
What?
You know who that is with him, don't you?
No.
Mr. Lionel. Hell, it is too.
Mr. Who?
Lionel Fellows, one of the Fellows brothers.
Doesn't look a very nice man.
You ain't whistling Dixie, Pixie. But the whisper is it was Mr. Lionel who set up the Cochran killings last year and took over the McNally operation.
You're kidding. The McNally mob?
Not anymore. It's the Fellows mob now. Okay, ladies. I'm sorry I'm going to have to take all these photos back. Oh, Mrs. Reynolds wants to look through them before you see them.
Yeah, I'm not surprised, but you can tell the ones of her in the shower didn't come out too well anyway.
Yeah, well, come on, Liz. Got them all? Hurry up, please. And that one as well. Thank you, Smith. Yep. Now, find something else to fill your time.
What are you going to do with that, bait?
Just hang on to it for a while. You never know. It might be very valuable.
Good evening, Mrs. Reynolds. Did you want to see me?
Yes, I want to apologise for being an Indian giver.
Oh?
These photos my son sent in for you. I'm afraid he sent in some
Important ones by mistake.
Oh, well, the women were wondering why you'd taken them back.
Yes, well, I'll return them as soon as Paul's sorted out the ones he needs.
Oh, good. They were very pleased with them.
Did they get to see them?
Oh, just a glance. Mrs. Powell came in just as we were going through them.
It's just that one or two are missing. They didn't happen to keep any by any chance, did they?
No, I don't think so. I'll ask when I get back if you like.
Thank you. Well, that's all I wanted.
Oh, he's a good photographer, your son.
Yes, he's not bad. He's hoping to make a career of it.
I'm sure he will. He has just the knack of catching people when they least expect it. Douglas is no gentleman, but he's no fool either. If he's meeting a big crim like that in broad daylight in a public place, it must be something big. And fellows must be calling the shots.
Perhaps they're blackmailing him.
Well, what do you reckon they got on him?
Perhaps they've found out that he's another one of Pixie's husbands. Douglas.
Got it.
You
beauty, Lizzie.
Thanks.
Got a game, Mrs.
Reynolds.
Before?
Oh, I'll explain later. Gosh, she'll have a heart attack running around like that.
Don't say that. Right, Mr. Douglas, I think I might just give you a ring tonight and disturb your sleep.
Yeah, well, but how are you going to get a phone call? The screws know that you haven't got anyone on the outside.
I'll con one of them. Barry's always good value.
Well, one of us can do it for you, because they know that we've got friends and family.
Oh, rub it in, why don't you?
Screw's getting suspicious, isn't it? Well, I'll do it. And just tell him I'm going to ring one of my boyfriends.
Oh, all right. But make sure you tell him the message is from me.
Sure.
I want that photo, Smith.
And I want a few answers. How come you're involved with Lionel Fellows?
That has nothing to do with you. It's departmental business, top secret.
Oh, come on, cut it out. Why would the department be dealing with a bad boy like Lionel?
Because we want to put him behind bars. I would have thought you wanted the same thing. He's the biggest drug runner around.
Yeah, sure I do. And so do the cops. So why don't they put their best D's on it instead of someone from the department?
I know what you're implying, Smith. I don't like it.
Yeah, well, nor do I. There is no way a jumped-up little clerk
be
from the
careful,
department...
Be careful, Smith. Don't go too far.
Oh, cut the crap, Douglas. I don't know what you're up to, but whatever it is, it stinks
that
to high
heaven. That is enough.
And what are you going to do about it?
Right, now this is for your benefit. If you don't hand that photo over, you're in more trouble than you can imagine.
Yeah, I'm sure I am. Big question is, who from? Okay. It's for sale.
Don't you blackmail me.
You're here and you're worried, and that means I am holding all the aces.
All right. The papa wants to keep this under wraps, so they may come to some arrangement.
Oh, good.
I'll tell them what you have to say.
Well, for a start, we want a full-time doctor. It is a basic bloody right, and we are sick to death of being stuffed around about it.
Go on.
Conjugal visits, and a social worker, and teachers, so the women have got something to do in their spare time.
Oh, is that all?
Oh, you've got to be kidding. But it will do for a start. Now, do be sure and get back to me soon, won't you? I'd hate to keep the women waiting too long.
Well, of course, I can't promise anything. But I'll see what can be done.
You do that. Well, ladies, you were right about Douglas.
You mean the old bugger's really up to something?
I'd stake my life on it. He isn't just departmental business, either.
Oh, he's always made out he was whiter than flaming white. What do you reckon he's gonna do, B?
I don't know, but he's running scared.
But how do you know it's not just because of the department?
Well, come off it. If he was on the level, they'd be turning this place upside down by now. Besides, he's agreed to all the little things I asked for.
Ripper! You mean all of them?
Well, I didn't want to be too greedy too fast. But we've got him by the short and curlies, all right. I'd like to know what he was up to with fellows, though. Hey, for a lady who's anxious to know who I am, you're sure keeping yourself to yourself. What's your game?
Nothing. Mate of mine from Barnhurst told me you were running the place, that's all. Helps to know who's boss cocky.
Oh, yeah? Barnhurst, eh? And what's her name?
Peggy. But you wouldn't know. We're from South Australia. Only been here a couple of days and got picked up trying to earn the price of a bed for the night. Real nice welcome.
That photo was needed as part of a departmental investigation, Smith. You knew that. I told you the last time we met.
You also mentioned something about a doctor, a social...
Don't backchat me, Smith! I do not bargain with criminals. Now, if you don't hand that photo over, I am personally going to turn this prison inside out. And God help the person found hiding it.
Well, you can do what you bloody well please. You can turn the place inside out, pull it apart if you want to, but don't expect us to clean up your dirty work.
Take this! Get her out of here! I want this prison searched now, and don't let Smith out of your sight until it's completed.
Yeah, well, the way the bloody screws are going, they're going to find that photo and quick smart, too.
I don't think so. Not as smart as they think they are. As a matter of fact, I'd still say we're way ahead. Just about to ask you the same thing.
I forgot something.
Yeah, so did I. I've got to teach you who calls the shots around here.
I wouldn't try it, Smith.
No, I could hand it over to you. Oh! Ah! No! Ah! Ah! All right, you can have it!
Oh, no, I'm gonna...
Oh!
No, no, no.
Set this up.
Come on, we'll not take your head off right cutting
shit. All right. It was Lionel Fellows.
Thank you, Miss Ferguson. Smith? Inspector Fields would like to talk to you about the photograph we know you have.
Oh, you're that sure I've got it, are you? And I suppose you want me to hand it over to him like a good little girl.
Look, Smith, I haven't got time to play games. What about this photograph?
Yeah, okay, you can have it. As long as you assure me you'll make good use of it against Douglas.
Yes, well, at the moment, there's no hard evidence except for this photograph. But if the allegations are true, he is going to find himself in very hot water.
Oh, good. I hope he boils in it. That bastard deserves all he gets. I'll get it for you.
Thank you.
Oh, by the way, Fellow sent a heavy in here to get that picture back. Her name's Dugan. I'd get rid of her in a hurry if I were you, before I do the job for you. Helen left herself wide open to a very serious charge because of the way she feels about you. She even came in here to make sure you'd be all right.
I didn't ask her to. I didn't even want her to.
Look, you can't go on kicking someone in the guts just because they're trying to help you.
Oh, can't I? She deserves everything she gets. I'll never forget what she put me through.
So that's what your precious new religion teaches you, is it? Bitterness and revenge.
You bitch!
What's going on here?
She attacked me. You little liar. She came for me and she went into the locker.
Oh, yeah, that'd be right. Come on. Thought you were about due for another stint in solitary.
Thank you.
to get.
It's all right. Everything's under control.
But Mrs. Power, what about me?
Just go back and join the others.
Linda,
do it.
Billy boy, just come and get me.
Well, there's a little problem at the gate here. Don't worry. Shouldn't take too long.
Yeah? What sort of little problem? Come on, you can tell me I'm a big girl. What's all the fuss about? Hey. You haven't got to let me, have you? Will you get me out of here? Get me out of here!
B, please. It's okay. We'll get you out of there. It's just a matter of time, that's all. Okay. There's a device rigged up here that can make a mess of everything if we're not careful. But don't worry. Everything's under control.
Hey, do you hear that, Bill? Now, you're not going to make me miss out and spend the night with all those fellows, are you?
Don't worry. If you miss the bus, we'll take you out to dinner ourselves. Have you got that?
Well, you better let me out of here so I can have a look at you, see which is the better bargain.
Don't worry. Won't be long. B.
Yeah?
I want you to take your bed and bedding.
Over the far corner of your room. Make a sort of barricade. Have you got that?
For a minute there, I thought you were going to make me an offer.
Just hurry up and get behind that bed. I won't take you to dinner if you keep arguing with me the whole night.
Yeah, all right.
Made a hell of a mess putting this one together.
It certainly has. 5 more minutes. I just hope we can work it out in time, that's all.
Hey, Bill! Looks like that dinner date is going to be a certainty.
I wouldn't bet on it. We're nearly through.
He's working like a demon, B. Scared his wife will get jealous if he takes you out.
Don't believe a word he's telling you. He just wants you all to himself.
You're the devil you know and the devil you don't. You must be a pair of mad buggers taking on this line of work.
One of the necessary qualifications, my dear. Touch of insanity. John, you've got one hell of a problem. You know that bastard's double-wired this thing. Like wire. They're all giving positive readings.
Damn, what do we do? Hey, you two got a bit quiet. What's happening? Haven't snuck off trying to get out of my dinner date, have you?
Hang on a minute, B. It's time for an educated guess, old son.
Thank you.
How do you feel, Smith?
A bit sore. It takes more than a little bomb to stop me, though.
Good.
How are those other blokes? Major Hunt and...
John Devlin.
Yeah, how are they?
I'm afraid Bill Hunt is dead, and it seems Sergeant Devlin might lose an arm.
Oh, God.
Get some rest, B. Be back in a second.
Now, Mrs. Smith, if you'll just sign this.
What is it?
Just a hospital formality. There's no need to read it. As I said, it's merely a formality.
Just a formality? You bastard.
Now, Mrs. Smith, it's merely a waiver exonerating the department from responsibilities for your injuries. Minor as they are.
Well, they might be minor to you. But to me, they're pretty important.
Now, Smith...
It never occurred to me that I could sue the department. But now you mention it, it could be pretty expensive.
You wouldn't dare.
Try me. I've got nothing to lose.
Why, what's happened?
Apparently, you and Lizzie were very friendly with an ex-prisoner, Jeannie Brooks. Mum, I think you called her.
Yeah, that's right. What about her?
I've got some rather sad news for you. She died last week.
God love, Mrs. Reynolds must have laid into you. You look as though you lost one of your best friends.
I did. We all did. Mum Brooks died.
Oh, babe. Good old mum. She didn't suffer, did she?
No, died in her sleep.
Oh, that's the way all the good ones should go. No pain. I need a few more people like her in here. Do you remember how she used to take all the young ones under her wing when they first came in?
Yeah. The only mum some of them ever had. She's more than that, though. And the risk she took when I was wandering around not knowing which end was up. She almost ended up back in here for helping an escaped con.
Yeah, well, thank God she didn't come back and die in this dump. At least she had a few good years out there.
And she never forgot us.
Hello, Walker. I want a word with you. What were you lacing your coffee with?
Nothing.
Don't give me that. It's a bottle of booze. Little gift from your girlfriend, right?
No.
I thought I told you not to trade with her.
Well, I got it before you said that.
Well, I don't believe you. You're a slow learner, aren't you? Well, maybe this will make you understand more easily. And in case you didn't get the message in the first time, don't deal with the freak!
I couldn't help it. Ruth and Phyllis made me. They want stuff brought in.
I am top dog around here. You do as I say.
But they'll bash me if I don't get them what they want.
Oh, and I'll bash you if you do. You're not doing badly, are you, Walker? And you've been in here a few minutes and already you're the meat in the sandwich. If I were you, I'd keep a very low profile in the future. And for the last time, keep away from the freak!
You'd find out sooner or later anyway. I've decided to sue the department over this bomb business. Don't think much of my chances, but I thought I'd give them a nudge.
I see. I wonder if John Farnsworth would be available.
John Farnsworth? Isn't he that bloke that had those two cops kicked out of the service?
Yes, I think it was something like that. I'll give him a call anyway. I'm sure he could help you.
That's the understatement of the year. Thing is, who's going to help the department?
What is this, Smith?
Oh, it's only a carbon copy. Maybe it's not too clear. No, that's all right. Discovers the bombing and raises a few questions about security in the prison. And, of course, it mentions the fact you tried to make me sign a waiver to clear the department and the deal if I dropped the lawsuit.
Where's the original?
It was quite safe. On the outside.
This doesn't mean a thing.
Well, I think we'll let the editor of Dispatch decide that.
Has he got a copy?
Not yet.
Will you settle out of court?
It'll cost you $30,000.
$30,000? You weren't even hurt, Smith. You'll be lucky to get $10,000.
15.
20.
I might be able to get approval for that amount.
The bloke that got killed, Bill Hunt, he had a wife and kids, and I want them to get half.
You're very generous with the department's money.
He was very generous with his life.
I want that letter.
It'll be destroyed when I get the money.
That's blackmail.
Oh, no. That's discipline.
You all right?
Yeah. I had about 6 weeks in bed, couldn't fix it.
You know what you mean.
Tony, what I said before about do-gooders...
Oh, forget it.
No, I'm sorry, I didn't mean it. You definitely don't fit into that category.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You know the rules, Smith. No fraternising with civilians.
Oh, come on, Miss Ferguson.
I'm sorry, Mr. Maguire, but this is a prison and we do have rules, regardless of the situation. You've been warned, Smith.
There aren't a few others around to hear that warning.
What are you talking about, Smith?
Well, it's a pity that Maxine isn't here. She must have done quite a lot of collaborating with a certain prison officer. She and your girlfriend.
You should be resting.
I'm sorry, what did you say?
You should be lying down while you got the chance.
I don't think I could. Anyway, I'm all right.
I suppose you're pretty close to Maxine.
She was a good kid. Couldn't wait to get out of this hole, though. Don't suppose I blame her.
Yeah.
Sometimes it drives you nuts.
I can understand that.
Can you?
I can try.
Tony.
Yeah.
Thanks.
What for?
Just for being here. Is she, Doc?
Not too good, I'm afraid, B. With Lizzie's heart condition, all we can do is wait and hope.
Oh, come on, love. Lizzie, come on. You silly old bugger. That heart's too big to throw in the towel now. Any change?
I think so.
Is she...
She's over the worst of it. Fever's abating.
Oh, thank God.
I don't know how she made it at her age, but she's going to be okay.
Okay, Smith, come on. It is time to get some rest now.
All right, Mrs. Powell. I won't give you an argument this time. How long have you been there?
No, I just arrived.
I didn't remember sitting down.
Yeah, how do you feel? Hey, fancy a cuppa?
Yeah. All the time I kept saying that she wasn't going to die. There's a voice in my head that keeps saying, what if she does?
Hey.
What if Lizzie loves her?
Hey, come on, she's going to be fine. Someone's obviously watching over Lizzie. You're the one I'm worried about, you know. You're the one that needs looking after.
I'm all right.
Now the worst is over, maybe you'll stop worrying about everyone else, eh? You know, I was watching you today. You really do care so much for that old lady. You're a wonderful person, B. You really are. B.
Well, I'd better get back to Lizzie. How is she?
Oh, there's no hurry. She's sleeping like a baby. I bet she'll be relieved when she finds out. And your wife and children, Mr. Maguire, I bet they'll be relieved too.
Look, I'm a bachelor from way back, Pixie. No wife or kids that I know of.
Oh, what a pity. You'll have no one to celebrate with.
Back up, Pixie. What's all this about celebrating?
What didn't I tell you? Oh, well, Dr. Collins says the quarantine will be over tomorrow so we can all go home. Except for us, of course.
I don't want to leave. I know it sounds ridiculous. But not right now.
You know, you start telling yourself that you're used to being in here. And I'm having nothing. But it's not true. I get so tired of everyone leaning on me. I think at this stage I forget I'm a woman. And that perhaps there's someone I can lean on. I need you, Tony. Don't go, not tonight. Stay with me. It's all we're ever going to have.
Look, I really want you, Bea, you know that. The officers.
They won't check for a couple of hours. Let's not waste it.
You sure?